So after playing video games as a kid, like since I can remember, and clocking in over 10,000 plus hours over video games over my period of life, I decided that it was time for a change. In this time period of 6 months, I have successfully bulked and built a masculine frame. I went from obese to skinny fat to finally having a masculine frame with muscle, and I created this YouTube channel and I created a plan for achieving wealth. I got a raise from $15 an hour to $20 an hour. I really improved my mental health and the activities that I was doing throughout the day, and I improved my relationships with my friends and family. All of these things that I've been able to do has allowed me to realize something about my time playing video games, is that video games steal the masculine drive to conquer and achieve. So video games, they steal our motivation in real life. It keeps us distracted from our problems in real life, even when our outside life outside the video game is just garbage. Being a level 90 Shadow Commander somehow compensates for your deficiencies in real life because of the insane amount of dopamine you get from playing video games. Once you stop playing video games, the curtains are pulled. You will know if you're where you want to be in life or not. Yes, this can be kind of scary, but it's also necessary for change. You become motivated to play the game of life, and if you're already leveling up in real life, you're even more motivated to do so. So many young guys who are playing video games all day, they watch anime, they smoke weed, and they're enveloped in this life that doesn't harbor them any long-term fruits because you're not doing any sort of work. Yeah, you can have a job at McDonald's or wherever, right? I'm certainly not shitting on you for having those jobs. I've had a job at Dickie's, the barbecue place, myself at one point. But you have to be working towards something, and if you're not, in the long term, you're really going to see how it negatively affects your mental health, your physical health, your relationships, your finances. Playing video games is distracting you from real life. I know from experience, because I spent a period of my life where I would wake up and play video games for 6, 7, 8 hours every single day. My life compared to now is just much better. So this leads me to the actual benefits of me not playing video games. So number one is higher productivity. Now, I don't know the exact science behind dopamine, but it's very clear that if you quit video games, your dopamine levels become more balanced. And so activities that would give out less dopamine become less boring. You know, doing things like reading, meditating, or working can even become fun once your dopamine levels are balanced. So I was able to work longer. I was able to introduce long-term fulfilling activities into my life, such as reading and meditating, and overall I was able to have a lot more productive lifestyle. Now number two is higher confidence. Now this is something that is not necessarily because of you stopping playing video games, but it's what you do with the time that you stop playing video games with. Working out, socializing with friends and family, getting a raise, just improving at work. Those are all things that are gonna increase your confidence because they're representatives of who you are as a person. And if you feel that these are leveling up, naturally your confidence is gonna level up as well. Now, number three is better mental health. So as I mentioned a little bit in the productivity side, when you cut out a lot of things that aren't necessarily towards your growth, instant gratification activities, I believe a lot of the times you will notice that your mental health is better. You know, when you cut out porn, when you cut out junk food, when you cut out video games, when you cut out nicotine, your life can feel a lot more fulfilling because you're replacing that with delayed gratification activities, which is reading, which is working out, which is working on a business. So I do feel a lot more happy and a lot more fulfilled and focused than before. And my mental health is amazing right now compared to what it used to be when I would play video games religiously, you know, 1 to 2 years ago. And yes, even when I would only play 1 to 2 hours a day. The next one is higher discipline. A better level of discipline. discipline. Your ability to delay gratification while cutting down on instant gratification. It's the ability to say no to the candy bar and go eat the chicken. It's the ability to not quit while you're on that second set of the workout and you just want to give up so much. This is something I really feel a lot. I just got back from a trip to California to see my family. So I was there for 5 days and I didn't work out at all, and we did eat out quite a bit, and I let myself indulge a bit. You know, I'm on vacation, right? I felt the kind of shame that was associated with me doing the instant gratification activities. I don't regret it, but when you go from the lifestyle of me meditating, reading, working on videos, and working pretty much just 24/7, when you go from that to living this lifestyle, you feel a lot less fulfilled, because ultimately you're living a life of less discipline. Once I came back, I just had a really amazing sense of gratitude for the disciplined lifestyle that I live. And this is what allows me to have high productivity, higher confidence, better mental health, and overall happiness. It's because of my discipline. So it's not about just quitting video games. It's about what you decide to fill that time with. Ultimately, if you quit video games but replace it with another instant gratification activity like watching anime, then you haven't changed anything. Though I do believe that you will have this mindset shift naturally over time, it's important that if you quit video games, you should do it with the purpose of improving your life in reality. I'm Nori. I motivate men through anime. Clearly, you're interested in that, so hit the subscribe and notification bell down below. Believe in me, who believes in you. Nori, signing out.